out on her own pennies like I had to. Now get out of the way.
I cannot tell you what a joy it is to see your happy, smiling face.
Oh, it's you, Fred, my departed sister's only offspring.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Ebenezer, and may God save you.
God save me from Christmas! Bah! Humbug!
Christmas? A humbug, Uncle Ebenezer? Come now, I'm sure you don't mean that.
I do mean that. Merry Christmas indeed. What reason do you have to be merry? You're poor enough.
And what reason do you have to be miserable? You're rich enough.
There's no such thing as rich enough. Only poor enough.
Oh, Uncle.
Nephew, what do you expect? I live in such a world of fools out upon Christmas Eve. What's Christmas time to you? But a time for paying bills without any money. A time for finding yourself a year older, not an hour richer. A time for balancing your books and having every item in them presented dead against you. Oh, if I can work my will, nephew, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
Oh, Uncle Ebenezer.
Oh, nephew. You keep Christmas in your way. Let me keep it in mine.
But you don't keep it, Uncle.
Let me leave it alone then. Much good may it do you. Much good it has ever done you.
Well, it's true that Christmas has never really put a scrap of gold or silver in my pockets. I believe it has done me good. And will always do me good. So I say, God bless it.
Yeah.
Let me hear another sound from you, Cratchit, and you'll be keeping your Christmas by losing your situation.
Oh, and you, sir.
You're quite a speaker. I wonder you don't go into Parliament. You're fool enough.
Come now, Uncle. Don't be angry. Come and dine with us tomorrow.
Dine with you tomorrow, nephew. I'm sure you know in which extremity I shall see you first. As though you haven't got enough problems, you got married. Now why on earth did you do a fool thing like that?
Well, because I fell in love with a beautiful woman.
Because I fell in love with a beautiful woman.
If there's anything more nauseating than a Merry Christmas, it's the hypocrisy of a happy marriage with some lovesick female. Good afternoon.
A Merry Christmas, Uncle Ebenezer.
Good afternoon.
And a Merry Christmas to you, Bob Cratchit. And to your family.
Well, thank you, sir. And to your good family, too, sir.
Thank you. Every season to be jolly, la-la-la-la-la-la. Oh, and Uncle, a Happy New Year.
I said good afternoon!
I don't wish to be impertinent, Mr. Scrooge. It would be too much trouble for me to ask for more wages, sir.
The trouble with you, Cratchit, is that all you think of is pleasure and squandering money. You'll be wanting the whole day off tomorrow, I suppose.
If it's convenient, sir.
Well, it is not convenient, sir, and it's not fair.
Christmas Day, Mr. Scrooge, it only comes once a year, sir.
A poor excuse for picking a man's pockets every 25th of December. I don't pay good money for you to be forever on holiday.
I appreciate your kindness, Mr. Scrooge.
That's my weakness. I'm a martyr to my own generosity. I give you one Christmas day off, you'll expect them all. Very well. Take the day, but be here all the earlier next morning.
Oh, I will, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. And a Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge.
Be gone from here and take a fellow Merry Christmas with you.
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. No offense, sir.
Another one. 15 shillings a week. A wife and 6 children, and he still talks about a Merry Christmas! Bah! Humbug! You belong in an asylum, the whole lot of you. Humbug!
Thank you.
finest bird in the shop. At least the finest for one in four bits.
Two bounds.
5 shillings, they are due before Christmas. Let me see, my, where has the time gone? That means today.
Well, you see, sir, what with it being Christmas, we've been giving people an extra week or two to pay. So it's
that
not...
That is your problem, madam. Mine is to collect £2, 5 shillings, now.
We sell children's things, son, and people can't afford to pay this time of year.
Well, neither can I.
However, I'll allow you an extra week's credit.
Oh, well, thank you, sir.
Which will only cost you a further 12 shillings.
12? Oh, but Mr. Scrooge, sir. You scarcely make that much in a week, sir.
If you prefer, madam, I shall confiscate your card and its contents,
no.
Which is my legal right to do.
No, sir, we'll pay.
We'll pay.
Oh, yes, okay, yes. And you both sign this. Yes, sign here. And let me use my pen. And give me a pair of these socks.
Yes, Mr. Scrooge.
Hello, you have a Merry Christmas.
And a Merry Christmas to you, Thunder. Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much. And Merry Christmas to you, Mr. Scrooge. What brought Mr. Scrooge? Small token of the Christmas spirit, compliments of Tommy Jones.
No.
And there'll be a free con every night throughout the coming year, sir. Just for my gratitude for infinite kindness in granting me an extra 2 weeks to pay.
1 week.
And they, sir.
1 week.
9.
1 week.
Yes, sir, 1 week.
And bring a lid on that super. I'll take it home.
Why, 2 coins, sir.
Thank you. Emma. Face. It was there on my door knocker. It looked like Marty, only like a bad lobster in a dark cellar.
Everybody goes, ooh!
What?
To which this light
could have conducted me. Ebenezer, hear me. My time is gone.
Oh, I will. Only don't be hard upon me, Jacob.
I have been sent here tonight, Ebenezer, to offer you a chance and hope of escaping my fate.
I offer you that chance, Ebenezer.
I thank you kindly, Marty. You are always such a good friend.
You will be haunted by three spirits.
Oh, is that the chance and hope you mentioned, Jacob?
It is.
No, I think I'd rather not.
The first spirit will come tonight when the clock strikes one.
One? Was that a little late? Couldn't we have them all at, say, 11:30 and get it over with?
Expect the second, Ebenezer, when the bell tolls two. And the third, when the clock strikes three.
Three.
Three. Ebenezer, remember what has passed between us this night. Look to see me no more.
Oh, I'd love to see this.
What are you killing, Ebenezer? Ebenezer, look to see me no more.
No more.
No more. No more.
Thank you.
Well, told me?
I am.
Well, who or what are you then?
Well, I am the spirit of Christmas past.
Long past?
No, your past.
Well, may I be so bold as to inquire, what business brought you here?
Your welfare, of course.
I cannot help but think that a night of unbroken rest would be more conducive to one's welfare.
Your redemption, then. Come, rise, walk with me.
I'm not sure that the weather nor the hour are conducive to pedestrian purposes. I am, after all, but a mere mortal.
Fair, with the touch of my hand.
Where are we going?
Well, we're going to see your childhood.
Oh, goody. waiting. I'm right here. Spirit, why doesn't she speak to me?
Scrooge, she can neither see nor hear you. For these are all but shadows of things that have been.
Well, she was a pretty little girl, wasn't she?
She was indeed, and she had a happy, joyous nature.
Oh, yes, she did.
I do believe that she loved Christmas, and all things to do with its celebration, did she not?
Oh, she did indeed, especially the singing of Christmas carols. It was one she could sing. That young man was myself, alone at school at Christmas time.
Oh, Ebenezer! Here,
we always did that. And then he fell down in the street. Ran away with so much fun.
She had a large heart.
Oh, she did indeed, a very large heart.
She died a woman, and I believe that she had children.
Oh, yes, one child.
Your nephew, Fred.
Oh, yes, my nephew, Fred.
Thank you.
Isabel.
As your week's daughter. You're going to marry her, aren't you?
Oh, yes, we were very happy.
So sweet and good for me, why'd I ever let took your love and crushed it with my green and heavy hand. Oh, my darling, oh, my dearest, oh, it seems so long ago that your love for me was endless. Now I know that isn't so, and I let you go away, dear. I untied the strings of love, and the saddest words I've spoken are the words, what might have been possible. Man, why do you torment me so? Take me back, spirit. Take me back.
You expect a twisted one. The second is two.
Nothing to be afraid of. I'm ready for you, whatever you are! No! You come here! This is my house!
Very well.
Pouring wine and wine, we thought.
I hope die in a mutual vow.
Time's on fire!
Life can die, will both right, regardless of how. And if life were a woman, she would be my wife.
Why?
Why? Because I'm my life.
That's all very well for you. I hate life.
Oh, rude. You aren't even a bigger fool than I took you for. Look here, Scrooge. Come here. Now repeat after me. I like life.
I like life.
The life likes me.
Life likes me?
I make life a perpetual spree.
A perpetual spree?
Eating food.
Oh, food is fine.
Thinking food like the privilege to dine with.
I like drinking the drink I drink.
That's better, Scrooge. I like thinking the thoughts I think. Come on, Scrooge. There's lots of visiting to do. You're in for a few surprises.
Let's go, let's go.
I like song, I like a chance. I hear music and I'm in a trance.
Ah.
Oh, Papa, chances are we shall get up and prance. Where there's music and laughter, happy just is right.
Why?
Why? Because I love.
Stuffing a la cratchit. Really one of the culinary myths of our day.
Christmas just
What's to become of him, tying him?
What's this, Ruth? Concern over a sick child? Have you taken leave of your senses?
Don't mock me, Spirit. Is the child very sick?
Of course he's very sick, Scrooge.
Will he live?
What's it matter to you, Ebenezer Scrooge? If he's going to die, let him do so. And decrease the surplus population.
As I said to the Lord Mayor, if a most gracious majesty is feeling bored, I said, just swing her down to Camden Town, I said. A glass of Bob Cratchit's hot lunch, and a song from young Tiny Tim, and we'll have her back on the regal feet in no time. Now there's the punch. Now where's our song then, my Tiny Tim?
I shall ask the questions, and Miss Potter, you can keep it. What?
A partridge! A partridge!
I'll be gone!
Oh, thank you!
She's so slim, as proud as...
Partridge!
Partridge!
That's it, I'm going now.
Wink!
A wink, you fool! A wink!
Am I in the presence of the spirit of Christmas is yet to come? And are you to show me shadows of things that will happen in the time before us?
Oh, spirit.
Spirit, I fear you more than any specter I have seen. But as I know your purpose is to do me good. Oh, it is to do me good, is it not? Then I will follow. So lead on, spirit.
Spirit, what is it that you want me to see?
Oh,
ladies of the evening. So I've been told.
There's some who say he's gone to heaven this very day. We say it just isn't so. For we know the story, he'll not go to glory. In fact, he went down below. For we know he's in hell, up to Ishaven cold.
Odds and ends?
Yes.
yes.
Your aunt take your fortune, and I dare say you'll do it.
You will, all right. But I've got the real prize. I've got it right here. You've got to take a look at it.
Hey! I can use that.
So can I, and I will. You can look at this shirt till you go blind in both eyes, and you'll not find one hole in it. Then we're going to bury him in it. But calico's good enough for him.
That shirt! It's mine! It was mine, but how did they get it? And who have they been talking about, Spirit?
Eh, we did all right for ourselves tonight, Ducky. I give the credit that old miser because she out in profit of us tonight. Now that he's dead!
Is to scratch wherever he may be!
He stole your cup, you
idiot! Hey! You stole it from me!
Scratch who, Spirit?
Spirit, if there is any person in this town who feels gratitude or emotion towards me, show that person to me now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're all gathered here today because we're all united in a common bond.
Yeah!
Namely, our feelings of gratitude for Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge.
Oh, is this the future Spirit? I know that man. That's Tommy Jones, the hot soup man. He owes me £6. I must say, he looks uncommonly happy for a man so deeply in debt. All these people owe me money. They all love me, and I never knew it.
We're all deeply moved. And those of us who have been in debt to Mr. S for all these many years will never forget the rare and beautiful thing that he has just done for all of us. Right?
Right! What did I do? What did I do? Whatever it was, it has made them truly happy. And I am the cause.
On behalf of all the people who assembled here,
yes!
I would merely like to mention in my mind that our unanimous attitude is one of lasting gratitude for what my friend has done for us tonight. And therefore, I would simply like to say, thank you very much. That's the nicest thing that anyone's ever done for me. I may sound noble Dutch, but me like is such. I feel as if nothing's more than one for me. And if I add me flag, I'd hang me flag out to add a sort of final ring for that. But since I have to pay, I'll simply have to say thank you very, very, very much. Thank you very, very, very,
for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us, thank you very much, thank you very much. That's the nicest thing that anyone's ever done for me. It isn't every day the fortune comes me well. I never thought the future would be fun for me.
Bugle I'd have to blow with to add a sort of algebra for the touch.
But since I left me bugle at home, I simply have to say thank you very, very, very much. Thank you very, very, very much.
It is I who should thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
The nicest thing that
very much
I've done.
Thank you very much.
The future.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very, 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 very much. And if I had a drum, I'd have to bang it to add a sort of rumpty-tumpty-touch.
But since I left me drummer at home,
since I left me drummer at home,
I'll simply have to say,
simply have to say, thank you very, very,
very much.
been magnificent. Sometimes I amaze even myself. Oh, Spirit, this is wonderful. Is there something else that you want to show me that is equally as wonderful? Yes. Oh, but Spirit, this is Bob Cratchit's house. But why are we here again?
Getting to the child.
Where is Tiny Tim?
Why look at the speed of the wheels, Mother? They should be done long before Sunday.
Sunday? You went to the church in Bob?
Yes, my dear.
I wish you could have gone. It would have done you good to see how green the place is.
It's
I must tell you of extraordinary kindness of Mr. Scrooge's nephew. He said I looked a little down and inquired what had happened and distressed me so much. I told him, I'm heartily sorry for Mr. Cratchit, he said. I'm heartily sorry for your good wife. By and by, how we knew that, I don't know.
You what, my dear?
Why did you want your wife?
Everybody knows that.
Well observed, my boy, I'll figure.
He said that if he could be of service in any way to comfort me, as if he'd known our time, he felt with us.
I'm sure he's a good soul.
I shouldn't be at all surprised if he got Peter in a better position.
Did you hear that, Peter? Go on.
It's just as well.
Tiny Tim, thy childish essence was from God. Tiny Tim can't be God. He's too young. Surely there is something that you can do. Yes, yes. Show me what you can do to make things better. Yes, things will be better.
I missed you today.
It's just not the same without you, Tiny Tim. I must go. I can't stay.
spirit. Surely there is something that could have been done. Yes, something that should have been done. Oh, yes, yes. There was something that I should have done. Oh, spirit. Spirit, I am so sorry. Oh, but spirit. Spirit, why are we still here? What else must you show me here? Ebenezer Scrooge! Oh, no, Spirit, no! No! I beg you! Oh, Spirit, hear me! I will not be the man I was! Oh, why have you shown me these things if I am beyond all hope? Oh, Spirit, Spirit, no! No, wait! Please, please, I beseech you, don't leave me! Don't leave me, Spirit! Oh, I will not be the man I was! I will honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year! I will live in the past, the present, and the future. Yes, the spirits of all three shall strive within me. I will not shut out the lessons they teach. Oh, all that I may wash away the writing on the stone. Truly, truly, I will repent. I will.
Thank you.
Yes, boy, what day is it?
Well, it's Christmas Day,
boy. Oh, it's Christmas Day. I haven't missed it. Boy, what is your name?
George, sir.
George, my boy. Do you know that butcher shop down the street?
Well, I hope so.
Oh, what an intelligent boy. And you know if that prized turkey is still hanging in the window? Yes, that's the one.
Yes.
It's still there? Oh, good. Go and wake up the butcher. Have him open up his shop. Come back with that turkey and I'll give you half a crown. Go, boy. Run, run. What a delightful child. I think I'm going to like children. Oh, now that's what I call a turkey. Well, come along. We'll open up the toy shop. This is... good morning, Dawkins.
Good morning, Mrs. Scrooge.
Merry Christmas! I want some toys, lots of toys. Yes, yes, yes. I'll take this. Never mind. I'll take the whole shop.
The whole shop?
Yes, how much will all that cost?
Well,
never mind. Here are some sovereigns. You can keep the change.
Yes.
And I shall require the services of several small children to help me transport these delightful objects to their destination. Each child will receive half a crown. Come along, come along.
Merry Christmas, Fred, my dear boy.
Yes.
And to your enchanting bride. Oh, and this must be my favorite niece.
Yes, Uncle
Scrooge. What is your name, my dear?
Penelope.
Oh, Penelope.
Yes.
Never forget your favorite niece's name. That's what? Oh, yeah. This is for you, my dear.
Thank you, Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, and these. These are for you from an old fool who deeply regrets all those Christmases gone by that he might have shared with you.
Oh, Uncle Ebenezer. Thank you. Now, Christmas dinner is at 3 sharp. Can we expect you?
Oh, yes, you can. Yes, I'll be there, my word.
Oh, you are a pretty girl. Even prettier than you were at the party last night.
Thank you very much.
As of today, all my debts are ended! Merry Christmas!
Thank you very much. That's the nicest thing that anyone's ever done. It isn't every day the work has done me way. I never thought the future would be fun for me. And if I had a cannon, I'd have to fire it. You had a sort of celebration touch. Say thank you very, very, very much. Thank you very, very, very much.
Gentlemen, here are 100 guineas for your most worthy cause.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
That's the nicest thing you've ever done.
Thank you very much.
The future.
Thank you very much.
In fact,
thank you very much.
I feel as if the ball is in the sun.
Thank you very much. And if I had a drum, I'd have to bang it.
But since I left me drummer at home,
since I left me drummer at home,
I simply have to say,
simply have to say, thank you very, very, very much. Thank you very, very, very much.
Oh, Merry Christmas, all my lovely new friends. I've got to leave you now. I've got to go and get ready. I'm spending Christmas with my family. Oh, good morning. I don't know whether or not you can hear me, and I don't know whether or not I imagined the things I thought I saw. But between the pair of us, we finally made a Merry Christmas, didn't we? Merry Christmas, Jacob Marley. And Merry Christmas, you lovely old world!